Déception sur le marché du travail aux États-Unis. Les inscriptions hebdomadaires au chômage sont en hausse. Alors que les analystes financiers espéraient une baisse des chiffres, ils ont finalement augmenté. 770 000 demandes d'allocation ont été enregistrées au cours de la semaine du 13 mars. Le consensus tablé sur 700 000. US Weekly Jobless Claims jump higher than expected.
Those initial claims, a real disappointment, at least in my book. We were looking for cycle lows. Current cycle low is 711,000 from November. This zoomed up to 770,000. Now, it's not that big, but it is not a cycle low, and it's actually the highest initial claim level since about mid-February when we were back over 800,000 versus 770,000. And if you look at continuing claims, a bit of a different picture. It definitely is coming in better than expected. I rephrase, not better than expected, but still a cycle low. We're expecting a number of 4.03 million, and we ended up with 4.124 million. That follows 4.14 million. That was the cycle low. So post-COVID cycle low on continuing claims, which are also still too high, and I'm sure we'll talk about some of the emergency programs that aren't in the headline breaking news. Philly Fed for March. All right, I carry a 28-year tail of data in my laptop. It came out at 51.8. The highest I had was 41.4 in 93. So this is a robust number for a March read on Philly Fed Index, and it really does underscore all the horsepower hidden in the economy that the Fed officials seem to be just oblivious to. And right now, we touched 250 in a 30-year bond. That was up 8 basis points. That's the highest level going, if it were to close there, since July of 2019. And at 174 in tens, that was up 10 on the day. Should it close there, that'd be the best close since January of last year. We'll call it 13 months. And after that statement yesterday, nobody was kind of thinking how dovish it was. I was. There was feathers in the room. And what gave you the clue was the dollar index. And it still isn't actually back up to where it was before the statement was read, but it vacillates. It looks at all the programs, all the stimulus, all the debt, all the watering down of the reserve currency, and it starts to cry a bit. But then it looks at interest rates. It's a tug of war, and it starts to move back up again.
Et tout de suite, Key Figure avec Sibylla Oudjane.